Coiled on the floor beneath the open turret window in the corner of the bedroom, you watch the distant white waves hiss and suck the sand, which you can see through a gap between two other pointed roofs, and you wonder why these things are happening to you. Catching a glimpse of yourself from above, you see a dark elf curled up inside a turret, with the shadow of a dagger clutched tightly on your left hand, the shadow of another dagger stuck into your chest, and your right hand diving to your chest right now to flap in horror at the surface of your bright red t-shirt, feeling for this unfamiliar dagger in your chest that you've just seen. But your hand finds only your little silver cross, while your left hand clenches the handle of its shadow dagger harder, harder, harder now than ever, and the sea sighs on, and a clump of old leaves rustle brittly in the gutter just beneath you. What's with those shadow daggers, Angel? Are they part of that luscious, fierce, anguish little body you're imprisoned in? Your red fingernails are like spray-painted petals broken sharp through your finger flesh. Did you ever feel as average people feel, or were you gorgeously twisted from the start? Tell me, do. You turn as if to camera, though I know you cannot see me, mouth, you'll never know, and turn away. What went so wrong with you? Or went so right, perhaps? You want to kill most human beings that you see. 20 times a day you think of stabbing with your shadow dagger through someone's forehead and deep into their brain, and this picture gives you peace and liberation. Under the dictatorship of Lucan, you inhabit a delirium of the senses. Yet at the same time, you've always felt somehow that you were buried alive. The black sky inside your head oppresses, claustrophobically immense. And rest assured, you will stay buried there, alive inside your poisoned night of dagger-skewered self until you die.